Welcome to CYS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently friends, we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics like ancient India, medieval India, modern India, art and culture, polity, history, geography, and science and tech, government schemes, international relations, current affairs. So in this manner, we daily discuss two topics, two subtopics, and in 6 days, your 12 subtopics are covered. So this process goes on and on in cyclic manner, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. Why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So let's start our discussion. So today is the fifth lecture about science and technology. So this includes the science questions from science as well as science and tech. So let's see what are the questions. First question is, which of the following roles is played by abscisic acid in plant development? One, it is a plant growth hormone. Second, it increases the tolerance of plants to various kinds of stresses. So we have to choose the correct answers. Friends, both statements are correct because this abscisic acid is a plant growth regulator, and it also increases the tolerance level of plants to various kinds of stresses. So the solution is C, that is both 1 and 2. So it was first discovered for its role in regulating abscission and dormancy, and it inhibits seed germination and stimulates the closure of stomata in the epidermis and increases the tolerance of plants to various kinds of stresses, for example dry conditions. So by inducing dormancy, it helps the seeds to withstand desiccation and other factors unfavorable for growth. So in this way, it helps in the growth of plants. So in a way, it inhibits the seed germination, but it only do so for the purpose of future plant growth, so that the seed can adjust itself to the adverse climatic conditions. So in a way, it helps in the growth of the plants. So this is about your first question. Let's move on to the second question. Second question is, which of the following are nitrogen fixing bacteria? First, Rhodospirillum. Second, Azotobacter. Third, Anavina. Fourth, Dibosenfica. So let me tell you friends that the nitrogen fixing bacteria, so out of these given bacteria is 1, 2 and 3. So Rhodospirillum, Azotobacter and Anavina, they are all free living nitrogen fixing bacteria. So answer is A. So free living nitrogen fixing aerobic microbes include Azotobacter, Bizernickia and Rhodospirillum. Rhodospirillum is your anaerobic and Bacillus free living. And this the most prominent among them is there are also nitrogen fixing bacteria that live in symbiotic relationship with other organisms, for example legume and the legume bacteria relationship, and both rhizobium and Frankia are free living in soil, but as symbionts they can fix the atmospheric nitrogen. So this is about your second question. Let's move on to the third question. Third question is, consider the following matches of Indian Navy vessels with what they are known for. First, Ahriman and Atulya, Navy fast patrol vessels. Second, Teahu, nuclear submarine. Third, INS Arihant, surface torpedo launcher. So fourth is INS Vikramaditya, aircraft carrier. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that only 1 and 4 are correctly matched. Second and third are not correctly matched because INS Arihant is a nuclear submarine. So you might be knowing about this fact that Indian Navy is in the modernization mode, and it has advanced vessel technology program in which it is developing its nuclear submarines. So INS Arihant is first of such nuclear submarine, and it is indigenously built. So only 1 and 4 are correctly matched. So the answer is 1 and 4. So solution is A. So these are Ahriman and Atulya are Navy fast patrol vessels that help in undertaking multifarious close coast missions such as surveillance, interdiction and search and rescue. This INS Teahu is a water jet fast attack craft. So this is not your that is given in your question. So this Arihant, as I have told you, that it is nuclear submarine, nuclear powered ballistic missile submarine. So INS Vikramaditya is the largest ship aircraft carrier to join Indian Navy, And learning is that Indian Coast Guard is a statutory multi-mission paramilitary organization which was established under 1978 Act of Coast Guard Act, and it is under the control of Union Ministry of Defence, and it exercises its jurisdiction over the territorial waters of India, including contiguous zone and exclusive economic zone of India. Let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, what do you understand by the term superbugs? A. An abnormally large insect species that is detrimental for agriculture. B. A virus that has the ability to replicate without a host. C. A deadly bacteria which cannot be treated by current antibiotics. D. A strain that is ahead than all planetary species on the course of natural evolution. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that the superbugs are basically, they are deadly bacteria which have developed a kind of resistance to the antibiotics. So the solution is C. So superbugs are those bacteria that have become not affected by the current antibiotics that we have. So it is expected that superbugs could kill up to 10 million people globally by 2050. So it is a big concern. Let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, if you close a healthy plant in polythene bag, you will observe that droplets of water are forming inside the bag. This happens due to the phenomena of A. Shooting of hormones in the stem. B. Photosynthesis. C. Energy conversion within the plant. And D. Is transpiration. Let me tell you, friends, that this process is basically transpiration, because this water in plants is basically it is in transient stage. So the roots pick up the water and the moisture, and it gets released in the form of the process of transpiration. So only 1%, less than 1% of the water that reaches leaves is used in photosynthesis. So certainly photosynthesis is not the answer. Answer is transpiration. So it is a process of releasing moisture from the leaves. Solution is D. So moisture is released through stomata in the leaves. So stomatas are surrounded by guard cells. So this is about your today's lecture, friends, about science and tech. And if you liked the video, if you liked the questions, then do hit a like and ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And also do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications relating to UPSC CSE 2019. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day.